الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وسلم تسليما. All praise be to Allah. I praise Him alone. I seek all forgiveness from Him alone. I seek all support from Him alone. He who Allah guides, no one can lead astray. And he who Allah leads astray, no one can guide. I testify that there is no one worthy of being worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the slave and messenger of Allah and the best of His creation. May the peace and prayers of Allah be upon him and his family and his followers. My dear brothers, the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one religion. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. The only religion in the sight of Allah is Al-Islam. And Al here means that it is one. Islam is one religion, one faith. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّا مَعَاشِرَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ أَوْ نَحْنُ مَعَاشِرَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ أولاد علات، ديننا واحد وشرائعنا شتى. That we prophets of Allah are like brothers of one father. Our religion, our faith is one, while we have some different sharias or differences in sharias. The faith is one. To worship Allah alone, to make salat, to give zakat, to make fasting, to make pilgrimage, all these are part of every religion that the prophets of Allah have received from Allah. There are some things regarding halal and haram that have changed from time to time. But other than that, the religion of Allah is one. It is one faith. It is Islam. That's why no one has an excuse to worship other than Allah in any form. And anyone who is worshipping other than Allah in any form, he is worshipping Shaytan. He is worshipping Shaytan. Worshipping the devil. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do not worship the devil, because he is a clear enemy of yours, and worship me alone. So it's either worshipping Allah or worshipping the devil. If someone worships prophets, then no prophet has ever told his people to worship him. So he is not worshipping the prophets actually. He is worshipping the devils who deceived him and made him worship humans like him who are the prophets. He who worships the angels is actually worshipping the devils. No angel would agree that he should be, that he become in the position of Allah, to be worshipped with Allah. And so are the pious people. If you are worshipping pious people, whether they are in their graves or they are alive, then you are, if they are really pious, you are not worshipping them, you are worshipping the devil. Because he is the one who has ordered you to worship him. That's why the Muslim should know his way, because the only way is to worship Allah alone. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, after forbidding us to worship the devil, he said, وَأَنْ يَعْبُدُونِي هَذَا صِرَاطٌ مُسْتَقِيمٌ. Worship me alone. This is the straight path. It is the straight path. There is no other path accepted by Allah. The mushriks at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to worship Allah, but not alone. They used to worship Allah and worship others besides Him. They used to supplicate to Allah and supplicate to others besides Him. They used to sacrifice for Allah and sacrifice for their gods sometimes. And that's why Allah did not accept their worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not accept your worship to Him if you worship others besides Him. In any means or in any way of worship, obedience is worship. If you obey someone to the degree that you think that whatever he orders you is true and that you must obey him in everything, then you are making him a god besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one has this position but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about obeying the messenger, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ. He who obeys the messenger, he has obeyed Allah. Why? Because the messenger does not speak from himself, does not order from himself. It's only a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. But who is to claim after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he is receiving revelation from Allah? Anyone who claims that is a taghut. He is not a pious man. He is a taghut. He is a subject. He is a person who has put himself or made himself as God. This is the definition of taghut. Anyone who is treated as God in any way is a taghut. Whether this way is to be supplicated to or to be obeyed. If you obey someone knowing that his obedience means disobeying Allah, and you accept that, then you are worshipping the taghut. You are worshipping the taghut. As Allah said about the Jews and Christians, اتخذوا أحبارهم ورهبانهم أربابا من دون الله. They have made their scholars, their monks, their rabbis, their priests, they have made them lords besides Allah. How? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam explained it to Hatim al-Ta'i, who was a Christian priest before becoming a Muslim. Because Hatim al-Ta'i, when he heard the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam recite this verse, اتخذوا أحبارهم ورهبانهم أربابا من دون الله, he did not know the full meaning of worship. So he said, O Messenger of Allah, but we did not worship them. Because worship in his mind did not include obeying someone when it takes to disobey Allah and accepting his ruling rather than the rule of Allah. He did not know that this is worship. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam pointed it out to him, and he said, "Alam yakunu yuhillu lakum al-harama fatattabi'unahum ala dhalik wa yuharrimu alaykum al-halala fatattabi'unahum ala dhalik Were not they, meaning your scholars, your rabbis, your monks, were not they changing what Allah made halal for you into haram, and you were accepting that? And vice versa, the opposite. Changing what Allah made halal into haram, into forbidden. Like nowadays, you have people who tell others, why are you doing such and such? If you tell them this is the order of Allah and the sunnah of the messenger, they say, no, don't do this. This is not good. So you are putting yourself in the place of God. You are becoming a taghut by saying this. And this is very dangerous. The Muslims nowadays, unfortunately, are falling into forms of worshipping the devil and forms of worshipping the taghut. Worshipping the devil does not mean what we have seen in the past years. Some weird activities of some youth, and they call it worshipping the devil. As if this is only the worshipping of devil. No. Worshipping the devil, you don't have to put makeups and do weird movements to be worshipping the devil. You can be wearing the best dress and putting a long beard and still be a worshipper of devil. When you supplicate to other than Allah, like those who supplicate to the dead people, when you put the order of humans in the position of the order of Allah and take it as binding as the order of Allah and change the rule of Allah to following the rule of humans, this is a form of worshipping the devil. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who learn their religion and follow the best. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in his book in the chapter of Al-Anbiya, Surah Al-Anbiya, he mentioned the story of Ibrahim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and how he was calling his people to worshiping Allah alone. And then he mentioned other prophets like Ismail, like the Kifl, like Idris, like the Nun, like Zakaria, like Yahya, like Maryam. Then he said, وَأَنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتُكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا وَأَنَا رَبُّكُمْ فَاعْبُدُوهُ. That those that we mentioned, they all belong to the same nation, the nation of Islam, the nation of submitting themselves to Allah in worship and not to associate partners with Allah in worship. And that Allah is saying, I am your Lord, I am the Creator, I am the perfect, I am the provider, so worship me and do not worship anyone else besides me. This is Islam. But unfortunately, Not only the previous nations have changed their religions into worshipping the devil in one way or another, but a lot of people who have Islamic names and claim to be Muslims, and yet they worship the devil just like the others worship the devil. Either by sacrificing for other than Allah, or supplicating to other than Allah, or by accepting the rule of other than the rule of Allah, and obeying other than Allah like obeying Allah, taking the man-made laws as if it is the religion of Allah and as if it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They give those ways beautiful names, but beautiful names don't change the facts. If you commit shirk and you call it a beautiful name, that will not be an excuse for you in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you do fornication and you call it a beautiful name, that will not save you from the wrath of Allah. If you drink intoxicating drinks and call your action a good thing, this will not save you. You cannot treat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like children. Who do you want to deceive? You are deceiving no one but yourself. That's why, my brothers, we have to learn our religion. We are in a time in which falsehood is being poured on us every day from all directions. We are receiving tons of falsehood in our homes through the TV channels, through whatever it might be. Now there are more ways, those Twitters and things like that. So we have to be very careful. You as a Muslim should not risk your religion. You should not, just for the sake of wasting time, go and listen to falsehood or subject your ears to hearing falsehood. Even if Shaitan whispers to you and says, go ahead, why are you afraid? Go ahead, just listen. You can tell right from wrong. No, you cannot. No, you cannot tell right from wrong, except by first studying the religion, studying the faith in Allah, what it means in the right way, all articles of faith to know them in the right way, studying your religions, why is this halal and why is this haram? Otherwise you will be a victim. You will be a subject of being swayed from the path. And unfortunately, in most of the times, you don't know that you are being swayed, until you fall into the big ditch of kufr and shirk. No one says, this is not going to happen to me. No. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, regarding the days before the last day, regarding the days near the end of time, he said, يُصْبِحُ الرَّجُلُ فِيهَا مُؤْمِنًا وَيُمْسِي كَافِرًا وَيُصْبِحُ كَافِرًا وَيُمْسِي مُؤْمِنًا. In one day, one could change his religion twice, and he doesn't know. He wakes up as a Muslim and sleeps as a kafir, or sleeps as a Muslim and wakes up as a kafir. How is that when he's sleeping? Because he dreams of the things that he has been interested in, watching in TV and watching and hearing in Twitter and here and there and there. And when he accepts that and becomes a kafir. We have to be very careful. We cannot have those two ditches of evil together. not learning the religion and subjecting ourselves to hearing evil and hearing falsehood. You cannot do this to yourself. It is very dangerous. Allah said, لا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Do not die except as Muslims. So it's your obligation to take care of yourself. It is your obligation to take care of yourself, to avoid hearing falsehood, to avoid indulging in falsehood. Don't indulge in any kind of falsehood. Run away from falsehood. We have an example in our predecessors. The students of the companions, in their time, some innovations began to pop up and come to their ears. What would they do? Tawus, he was a great scholar, the student of the companions. When he heard someone who was speaking falsehood, he did like this. And he said, close your ears, my son. He is telling his son, close your ears, because this heart is weak. Don't subject yourself to falsehood. Don't be fooled by those who tell you, well, we listen to it and then we decide. You decide on what basis? You have no knowledge. You decide on what basis? If you think that you, by thinking only, you can tell falsehood from right, you are wrong. Why did Allah send books? If this was enough, why did Allah send books? Why did He send messengers? Why did He subject prophets to be killed, to be tortured, to be insulted? Why? The knowledge is in the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that must be acquired and learned. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ بِالتَّعَلُّمُ. Knowledge is only by seeking knowledge. You don't get knowledge by khuruj, as some brothers claim. Just go out with a good intention and you will learn everything. You don't get knowledge by kashf or kushuf or ilham, inspiration and things like that, as the Sufis claim. No. That's why the Prophet ﷺ has encouraged us so much to seek the knowledge. مَنْ سَلَكَ طَرِيقًا يَلْتَمِسُ فِيهِ عِلْمًا سَهَّلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ طَرِيقًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. He who seeks a path to learn the knowledge of Islam, Allah make it easy for him to go to paradise. The angels put down their wings as a sign of humbleness for those who go and seek the knowledge of Sharia. This is the knowledge that is meant in the Quran and the Hadith. The knowledge of Sharia, the knowledge of halal and haram, the knowledge of our faith and our belief. We have to learn all this. Even if you learn all the knowledge, you don't go and subject yourself to falsehood unnecessarily. You don't need that. This is not Islam. Whatever shaitan whispers to you, this is not Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if you hear those who indulge in our verses, indulge in falsehood regarding the verses of Quran, they give it false meanings and things like that, then don't sit with them. See, Allah is not only telling you don't listen to them, don't sit with them. If you do, you will be one of them. If you insist and sit with them, you will be one of them. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لَعَنَ اللَّهُ مَنْ آوَى مُحْدِثًا, narrated by Muslim. The curse of Allah be upon those who shelter innovators. Why? Because you are subjecting yourself to their falsehood. That's why Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad رحمه الله said, لا تجالس صاحب بدعة فإني أخشى أن تنزل عليك اللعنة. Do not sit with an innovator because I fear that the curse of Allah comes down upon him. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to send down his curse upon us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be merciful to us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the right path and to guide us to understand the right religion and to guide us to seeking the knowledge of his religion. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for Muslims wherever they are and to defeat the enemies of Islam wherever they are and to support those who are doing the best to strive in his path. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وأقم الصلاة.